हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू ई कंटेंट स्टडी एट योर डोर स्टेप ऑफ ऑल इंडिया श्री शिवाजी मेमोरियल सोसाइटी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी. आई एम विक्रम देशमुख, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट इंजीनियरिंग साइंसेस डिपार्टमेंट AISSMS IIT पुणे. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कवर टॉपिक इन इंजीनियरिंग मेकॅनिक्स, रिजिड बॉडी आयडियलायझेशन. सो दिस इज द मेन आयडियलायझेशन इज अज्युम्ड इन इंजीनियरिंग मेकॅनिक्स. फ्रॉम फिगर यू कॅन गेट लिटल बिट आयडिया अबाउट रिजिड बॉडी. सो लेट अस डिस्कस इन डिटेल व्हॉट इज रिजिड बॉडी आयडियलायझेशन. So, statement for rigid body idealization is, the rigid body is the body in which distance between all particle remain constant, or in other word, deformation is zero under the action of applied force. So now, what do you mean by idealization? Idealization means assuming an ideal situation. Okay, now question arises, why do we assume things? Why do we idealizing things? So we are idealizing thing in order to simplify our study. So practically, if you consider all situation practically, all situation are very complicated, and if you consider the exact thing, and if you consider exact situation, sometimes the calculation become very complex, the study become very complicated. So in order to simplify our calculation, we sometimes assume thing. As we know, in every derivation you study what are the assumptions for this derivation. So just like that, there is a very important assumption or a very important idealization in engineering mechanics. So what is that idealization? Let's see. The whatever body that we consider under the action of applied force for analysis in engineering mechanics is a rigid body. Now, what do you mean by a rigid body? It means there is no deformation in the body at all. Now, what do we assume that a rigid body is a body in which two points inside a body will be at same distance after application of any external force. For example, let us say this is a rigid body. This is a rigid body which is subject to a lot of forces from all directions, and there are two points inside a body, let's say point A and point B. Now in strength of material, this point will not be at same distance after application of external force. Why? Because in strength of material, distance will increase if you apply tensile force, and if you apply compressive force, the distance will decrease, because no body in this universe is perfectly rigid. So after application of force, there might be slight changes in the shape of the body, it may deform slightly. So engineering mechanics, we consider that deformation. Why? This is why, because we will consider deformation in strength of material, but in engineering mechanics we will not consider deformation, whereas we will assume that the distance between these two points, distance between point A and point B, will not change at all, whatever the distance is will be same. They will not move with respect to each other. That means there is no relative displacement between point A and B. Body can move, whole body as a whole can move under the action of applied force, but it is assumed that there is no relative distance, a displacement between point A and B. Now, why we need this idealization? Let us discuss. Why we need this idealization? So let me give you a very simple explanation, a very simple example. So consider a cantilever beam as shown in figure. Let's say I am applying force of 100 Newton at point A, at the end point A, and this point B, and there is a distance of 2 meters between point A and B. If you ask to calculate moment at point B, what you are going to do? I want to calculate the moment at point B. So what you are going to do? You are going to multiply 100 with distance between point A and B, which is 2 meter. So moment become 2. So the moment become, so the moment become 200 meter. So moment become 200 meter, Newton meter, sorry. But if this calculation is this exact value? No. Why? Understand. When you apply force on this beam as shown in figure, it is not going to be straight. This body is going to deform under this force as shown in figure. Here I am exaggerating the deformation. Now tell me whether this distance between A and B will be exactly 2 meter after application of 100 Newton force at point A. No, this distance will not be exactly 2 meter. This distance is going to change slightly. And if I calculate moment by considering deformation, it is going to very complicated calculation. A very complicated analysis, and final answer will not be very different from 201 that we have calculated assuming rigid body, and it will be somehow 200.00 something. And as per our idealization or assumption, if we ignore this small deformation, you are saving lot of time. You are saving lot of efforts. So that's why this is very important assumption that all bodies will be rigid body. This is the explanation for this example. Now let us summarize what we have learned. In this lecture, we have understand or we have discussed about the rigid body idealization in engineering mechanics. Here are some references for further reading of engineering mechanics. Here are some links of AISMS IoT e-content section. You can see different video lectures by visiting that website. There are some Swayam portal links and SPPUE Pune University links also. You can visit that website for further study. Now let us stop here. Thank you all. Have a nice day. Happy learning. Let's learning continue. Thank you.